The Anti-Corruption Court in Kampala was set to start hearing the case in which Bududa Woman Member of Parliament and State Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Agnes Nandutu, is charged with dealing with 2,000 suspected iron sheets meant for the vulnerable Karamajongs. As court convened today, Nandutu's lawyers, led by Kale Balaka, said they cannot proceed with the hearing because the charges against his clients were imprecise, and as such, her right to a fair hearing will be infringed upon.
By stating that it is unfair, unconstitutional for a person to go through a trial when the provisions of the law under which that person has been charged are vague, ambiguous, broad, and imprecise.
Alaka noted that the charges against Nandutu are not clear as it is supposed to be in law. This is because the charge sheet specifies one offence of dealing with suspected property, but in the particulars of the offence, prosecution seems to introduce another charge of causing loss of public property. Alaka went ahead and filed a constitutional petition seeking for the interpretation of the offence of Section 21A of the Anti-Corruption Act, where Nandutu is being charged. The petition also seeks to hold the trial in the Anti-Corruption Court.
The question, my lord, is whether Section 21A1 and 2 of the Anti-Corruption Act, Act of 2009, as amended by Act 12 of 2015, under which the accused has been charged with, is inconsistent with or in contravention of Article 28(1) and 12 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda 1995 as amended.
In response, prosecution led by Jonathan Mwaganya and David Bisamunyu opposed the halting of a trial, saying the charges against her are clear and there is no question that requires constitutional interpretation. Describing the petition as merely a delay tactic, Bisamunyu insists that trial must proceed.
My lord, the applicant decided to have a two-pronged approach by having both a petition and again applying for a reference. I know that amounts to a fishing expedition. If you filed a constitutional petition, the procedure is very clear. My lord, I have not seen any evidence of a temporary injunction order.
According to prosecution, they came ready with witnesses to testify against Nandutu, and the tactic of asking for a reference is a delay tactic. Prosecution therefore asked the court to dismiss Nandutu's application with contempt and go ahead with the trial.
Pray, my lord, that this application be dismissed with all the contempt that it deserves, as it's merely a delaying tactic to a speedy trial as envisaged by Article 28. Sub Article 1 of the Constitution.
Try a person, an accused person. If perhaps the section under which the person has been charged is indeed unconstitutional. And my lord, whatever the case, the Constitutional Court can interpret that section and say it's constitutional. And the trial continues.
Lady Justice Jane Kajuga adjourned the matter to the 29th of May 2023 to deliver her ruling on the application. The prosecution alleged that during the month of June 2022 at the office of the Prime Minister's stores in Namanve and Kola Cell, Bulwani Parish in Mukono District, Nandutu dealt with 2,000 government-prepaid iron sheets, gauge 28, by receiving and holding the said iron sheets. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.